In this video, we're going to be looking at the pressure altitude block in the Simulink Aerospace block set. We're going to start with a quick review on what the 1976 standard atmosphere is. Then we'll talk about what pressure altitude is. Then we'll talk about the pressure altitude block and some of the options that it has. Let's get to it. So the 1976 US standard atmosphere is a model of how different air properties change as you change your height or your altitude. So you look at things like pressure and temperature and density and viscosity as you change your altitude. And this becomes a quote unquote standard day or a standard atmosphere. And this model is based on assumptions and formulas or scientific principles, as well as test data that's actually been collected by flying stuff through the atmosphere. And it's useful for doing stuff like performance calculations or pressure altimeter calibrations, even some of the design aspects that you have. You'll assume a standard atmosphere or a standard day. And so this standard atmosphere is a general model of the air properties in the atmosphere. And since we're talking about pressure altitude in this video, the standard atmospheric model is that pressure decreases with altitude. True altitude is the height that you're flying above sea level, and pressure altitude is the height that it feels like you're flying at based on the actual non-standard atmospheric conditions of that day or of that local area that you're flying in. And that pressure altitude is actually more useful for performance calculations and determining what the aircraft can currently do in the current atmospheric conditions that it's flying in. And so, the only time that pressure altitude and true altitude are the same is when standard conditions exist locally where you're flying. Let's look at a quick example here on the right to help it make more sense. Let's say that your true altitude that you're flying at is at 5,000 feet. If the local atmospheric conditions are the same as standard atmospheric conditions, then your pressure altitude and your true altitude are going to be the same. This is hardly ever the case because the idea behind a standard model is it's an average over changes in time and an average over changes in location and other assumptions like dry air. So let's say locally that the pressure that day is lower than normal, lower than the model. If that's the case, even though you're flying at 5,000 feet, the aircraft feels like it's flying at a higher altitude. It has less air moving around the plane, around the airfoil, around the control surfaces, and so it's not going to be able to perform as well as it would on a normal day at 5,000 feet. And so the aircraft feels like it's flying, let's say, at 6,000 feet. This 6,000 feet is what we call the pressure altitude. And we'd use this pressure altitude in the performance calculations to determine how our aircraft is going to perform. For instance, what's its landing or takeoff distance, its range, endurance. Now let's say that you're flying on a day with higher pressures than the normal standard atmosphere. Even though you're actually flying at 5,000 feet, because the higher pressure has more air that's flowing around your wings, flowing around control surfaces, the aircraft feels like it's flying at a lower altitude. And let's just say 4,500 feet. And so the pressure altitude of 4,500 feet is what we'd use in the performance calculations to determine what the aircraft can currently do. So let's go ahead and take a look at the pressure altitude block in the Simulink Aerospace block set. This block can be found if you open up the Simulink library browser, navigate to the Aerospace block set. If you expand that, you can see that there is an environment category. If you open that up, you can see that there's a subcategory called atmosphere. If you click on that, you can see the blocks in that subcategory. And the block we are talking about is this one at the end called pressure altitude. So you can drag and drop that onto your Simulink model that you are creating. When it comes to measuring the atmospheric pressure on an aircraft, there's usually a static pressure port for reading in that pressure. There's usually a hole or something located on the side of the fuselage somewhere, as shown in the image here, or they might pull it off of the pitot-static tube. But the idea is to get the atmospheric pressure and not the total or stagnation pressure. And so you read in this atmospheric pressure and you can determine your pressure altitude. Now, Simulink has a block to do this. And so you can feed in your measured atmospheric pressure. And this can be a single scalar value or an array of values. So if you collected test data, you could feed this test data back into your model. And then the pressure altitude block is going to output the aircraft's pressure altitude, either as a scalar or an array of values. So the idea with the example here on the right is that I have marked a yellow static pressure port on the aircraft that we read in the atmospheric pressure around the aircraft, and we can use that to calculate the pressure altitude. So if we were flying at 5,000 feet, however, due to the local atmospheric conditions, the aircraft feels like it's flying or has the performance as if it's flying at 4,000 feet. The pressure altitude block comes with a couple of different parameters that you can set. If you go ahead and double click on it, you'll see that you can change what units the block operates in. So if you're doing metric, you can see that you can import pascals and get out meters. Or you can change that to English units, and then you would have the input be in PSI and the output would be in feet. The other parameter you can set is what action is going to be taken if the pressure input that you get to the block is outside the range of this standard atmospheric model. Now, if it's outside the range, it will extrapolate a value. So for instance, if you choose the action of none, meaning that there's not going to be any action taken if it goes outside of this range, it's just going to extrapolate a value exponentially based on the beginning or end values that you've gone past. However, you can also set it to warning or error. The error will for sure stop your simulation if it goes out of range. Now, for a warning, it depends on your model properties, whether it stops the simulation or not. That's one of the settings that you can adjust so that warnings either stop your simulation or they don't. And the range that it looks for on the input is between 0.3961 pascals to 101,325 pascals. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And taking a look at the aerospace block set, there are over 150 different blocks in the block set, and I'm just going to be choosing them in a random order. So if there's a particular one you want me to get to earlier rather than later, drop me a note in the comments. And I'll see you in the next video.